Okay, I just showed you the tile method for the thin brick. Now I'm going to show you the masonry way for adhered veneer and natural stones. But first, I want to make sure that you understand that the old mason way is not the way of doing it now. So when you have a piece of stone, and you're not using type S mortar anymore, instead of buttering the backs like you would with type S mortar, creating the ring for suction, we've all seen this done on many jobs. This can be an issue. One, it allows for air pockets to happen where you can have freeze-thaw effects. The other is you're not getting consistent coverage across the back, and you're not getting good transfer to the wall and the stone at the same time. When these are being set, you always gave it kind of the wiggle and jiggle, and then you had to hold it in place. With the new mortars, you don't have to do that. If you're doing the freehand, you mix it to the consistency that you need, and then you're gonna start setting your veneer stone. We already had these clean and proper. What I want you to do differently is take the stone and you're gonna put some mortar on the back. You're gonna give it a quick scrape. Instead of back buttering it like you did on the old ones, you're just gonna give it a quick scrape, and then you're gonna put some of the mortar to an even consistency on the back, okay? Almost the same way, but I want it to be solid all the way across. Then you're gonna take the piece of stone, you're gonna place it into the wall, give it a nice firm pressure, give it a nice slide, and then back into place and let go. All right? Once you get to that point, any of this excess mud, you can take off. And that's the reason for the square notch trowel on the back. So any of this mud, just take it off. That's money that you're saving down the road. Okay? Once you get that set, then you can go to your next piece. Same process, just a quick skim is all you need. That ensures you're getting good transfer to the back of the stone, and then butter it up to get the coverage that you're requiring. Then you're gonna take your next piece of stone, press it into place. Always start right next to the piece of stone that I already set. Press it, give it the slide, and then back into place and let go. It's that simple. Take any of that excess, put it in the bucket, anywhere we can get it. Then we can take our other piece. Set it the same way. Nice line, and then back into place. And we'll do our last piece. Kind of give you the idea of how it works. Quick skim, that's all it takes. And butter it up. I just increased my bond strength 2-3 times versus just putting it onto the back of the stone. Just want to try to make sure we're getting good coverage. Start on top of the next piece, give it a quick slide, back into place. You got a joint or not? You do. I put a little bit too much mud in there. Before I collapse it, I want to remove that just to make sure I don't have a big buildup in the joints. Now the other thing you can do is readjust with these products. You have a stone that doesn't quite look right, you can move that and put it back into place instead of type S and starting over. Now we'll look at some of the new products that are coming out that you have to deal with and install with those.